Hello friends, this video on data handling part 11 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. So based on whatever we have learned on bar graphs, let's try some questions. Question number one, observe this bar graph and which is showing the sale of shirts in a ready-made shop from Monday to Saturday. Now answer the following questions. Okay, so you are given a bar graph. So here horizontal bars are drawn and you will have to answer these questions. So basically you need to interpret the graph. What information does the above bar graph give? So this bar graph gives information about the number of shirts sold on different days. That means how many shirts are sold on each day. Like Monday, 15 shirts were sold. On Tuesday, some 10 shirts were sold. So this tells us number of shirts sold on each day. Next question, what is the scale chosen on the horizontal line representing the number of shirts? So what is the scale that is chosen? So you see, this represents one unit, that is one square on the bar graph. So one unit is taken as 5 shirts because on the x-axis you represent shirts. So for number B, you would say that one unit always refers to one square. So one unit represents 5 shirts. Third question, on which day were the maximum number of shirts sold? How many shirts were sold on that day? So where do you see the length of the bar maximum? Obviously on Saturday. So on Saturday, maximum number of shirts were sold. And how many shirts were sold? So what does this represent? So when you actually try to see this, it represents some 60 shirts. So on Saturday, 60 shirts were sold. Fourth, on which day were the minimum number of shirts sold? So where do you see the smallest bar? On Tuesday. How many shirts were sold on Thursday? Where is Thursday? This is Thursday. So let us see where does this end meet. So this end meets at 35. So 35 shirts were sold on Thursday. Question number two, the number of mathematics books sold by a shopkeeper on 6 consecutive days is shown below. Okay, draw bar graph to represent above information choosing the scale of your choice. So we can choose any scale of our choice. The first thing that we would do is we would draw the axis. So firstly, we draw a horizontal axis and a vertical axis. In the horizontal axis, we consider the days, and on the vertical axis, we consider the number of books. So let's look at the range of number of books. So the number of books values vary from 20 to 70. So the values lie somewhere between 20 and 70. So what is the scale that we chose? The scale is chosen as one unit represents 10 books. That means one square represents 10 books. So this is the scale that we have considered. So now let's draw the bars. What about Sunday? Sunday 65 books are sold. So this is 60. So somewhere here would be 70. So exactly between 60 and 70 would be 65. So this is the bar for Sunday. Monday is 40. So you see the height of the bar is 40. Tuesday is 30. So the height of the bar here is 30. Wednesday is 50. So here the height of the bar corresponds to 50. Thursday is 20 and Friday is 70. So this is how we can draw the bar graph. So with this, we have reached towards the end of this lesson, and I hope that these basic concepts on data handling would have helped you. So try to draw some graphs on your own and see if the concepts help you. If you have any doubts or any questions, feel free to ask them on the Ask Questions section of examfear.com. So I hope this lesson would have helped you. See you all in the next lesson.
Thank you. Please visit examfear.com for free quality education. You can learn with a simple 4-step learning process wherein you can watch video lessons, you can ask your questions, you can refer notes, and you can take a free online test. We have content for class 6 to 12 on physics, chemistry, mathematics, and biology along with practical videos. So please subscribe to our channel for daily updates. Thank you.